Hello, my name is Steve Stump, and you know me as Insure Me Steve, where getting stumped on your health and life insurance is the best thing that can happen to you. You know, I help business owners and self-employed professionals tailor health and life insurance policies to their specific needs. And I came across an article that predicted what may happen in the next decade, especially with the gig economy. And the impact it's going to have to health insurance in the United States. It was a really interesting article, and it made me want to dig a little bit more into the growth of the gig economy and form my own point of view and opinion on what that impact might be. So let's dig in. The article was on Marker. And it talked about, among other predictions, the transition to the gig economy and how it would upend the U.S. health insurance market. It was fascinating for me to learn, as I dug more into this, how fast the gig economy has grown and how fast it will continue to grow. In just the past 10 years, it has doubled in size of the number of people involved in the gig economy, and it's actually expected to grow up to 50% of the U.S. workforce in the next 10 years. Amazing growth. Now, there's a lot of trends fueling this. A study by Intuit, makers of TurboTax and Quicken, found that 80% of major U.S.-based companies will use the gig economy to supplement their workforce. So what this means is they are going to be reducing their W-2 employees and replacing them with contract employees willing to work for themselves, but with contractors like this study suggests, 80% of the U.S.-based companies. And then there's a lot of motivations behind why the workers will be available to support this gig economy transition. 90% of U.S. workers consider a side gig now, and 63% of those actually leave their full-time employment for their side gig. 70% of gig workers state that because they control where they work, how they work, and when they work, that they have a better work-life balance. So there's a lot of motivations that will continue to drive the size of the gig economy. So as I started to understand the amazing growth that's happening, I was really interested what the impact to the health insurance market would be within the U.S. So let's take a look at an independent contractor versus an employee. An independent contractor is what's known as a 1099 contractor, meaning they don't receive a W-2, they're not considered an employee. Big difference is because they're not an employee, they're not eligible for the benefits that a company may be providing to its employees. One of those big benefits is, of course, health insurance. So on the independent contractor side, they will actually have no health insurance from the companies that they work with. Whereas when you're an employee, you have the option to enroll into their health insurance plans. So if the gig economy is going to grow to half of the U.S. workforce, there's going to be a lot of independent contractors looking for health insurance benefits. So I've shared this chart before. This came from the Brookings Institute as they studied the impact of the Affordable Care Act across the health insurance industry. Now, the Affordable Care Act was created to be affordable care for all, but in reality, what they were trying to do was force healthy individuals into health insurance plans to offset the problem that's shown in this chart right here. Our healthcare expenditures in the U.S. is a classic 80-20 problem. 25% of the population drives well over 80% of the expenditures in the U.S. In fact, this suggests about 85%. So 25% drives 85% of our healthcare expenditures. Now, half of those healthcare expenditures are just driven by 5% of the population. That's at the top part of that chart, that 95 95th, 99th percentile, and then the inclusion of the 99th and the 100th. And what's happening with health insurance since then is the cost of health insurance has continued to steadily increase year after year after year, because the cost of those individuals that are driving those healthcare expenditures have to be spread across the population. And recent regulations with the Affordable Care Act have actually allowed other alternatives where people aren't forced into those plans. Now, if you look at the gig economy and the participation of the generations in the gig economy, obviously the younger generations, the Gen Zs and millennials, participate at a higher rate than the Gen X and the boomers. So typically you're healthier when you're younger. And so this impact to the health insurance industry in the US is going to be really fascinating. So you see here, going back to this chart with the Brookings Institute, that 75% of the population actually drives about 15% of the healthcare expenditures. So if healthcare is going to continue to increase because of the chronically ill individuals and the cost that they put into the healthcare industry, and yet the majority going into the gig economy and who will need health insurance are relatively younger and therefore healthier, they will be seeking other alternatives for health insurance other than what they can get in the Affordable Care Act marketplace. Those plans tend to be very costly and high deductible. They have to be structured that way to be able to balance the risk across the individuals in the insured plans. The analogy I like to always use is if you are a insurance company and you insure automobiles, you have to have good drivers in your insurance company along with bad drivers. The reason being is if the insurance company only insured bad drivers, all the rates would go up. Well, with health insurance, there are now companies like the ones I work with who provide an alternative to costly plans structured to be able to cover the individuals with chronic conditions and pre-existing conditions. And these plans typically bring the premiums down 40 to 50%. So what I see happening here as the gig economy grows is that more younger individuals and gig economy workers will be seeking alternatives to the Affordable Care Act marketplace plans and either not accepting to, or accepting not to take any insurance, or they won't accept an ACA plan and they'll go for what's known as an off-the-marketplace plan. Now, the article ended with an interesting quote, and I wanted to share this. By disassociating healthcare coverage from employment, because of the growth of the gig economy, this will make the U.S. labor markets more efficient, boost small business formation, dramatically improve the health outcome of Americans in the long term. It was an interesting quote. I don't know if I fully agree with all the points in that quote, but I do believe increasing or the growth in the gig economy will drive individuals away from these costly, high deductible plans, and they will be seeking alternatives. If you are one of those individuals in the gig economy, you're running your own business, and you are struggling looking for health insurance, feel free to contact me. I can be found at insuremesteve.health, insuremesteve.life. Here's my phone number, and I'd be happy to explore health insurance needs for you. This growth in the gig economy is an interesting topic that I'm going to focus on for the rest of this week. And I've got another video on how I believe the gig economy is going to drive banking in the future and what the options are to those solopreneurs that are looking to fund the growth in their business. Thank you for listening. I hope you have a great day. And if you ever have any questions, I'm always available on my social channels and available by phone as well as email. Thank you for listening.